I'm Annie Louey. I'm a comedian, and in a past life, I used to be a funeral assistant. To destigmatize the topic of death, I'm taking a bunch of performers and comedians on a ride with me.
So get ready to hear it straight from the hearse's mouth.
Hello.
Good morning.
That door is heavier than my own car.
It's a workout, every part of this.
Claire Hooper is a national treasure, having started her career as a stand-up comedian on shows like Rove Live. And now she's a co-host on The Great Australian Bake Off. On stage, Claire is a natural storyteller, and she's got a rockin' wardrobe to boot.
I like the top that you're wearing today. It kind of matches what we've got going on.
Okay,
so
I was trying to wear bright colours. The last funeral I went to was for somebody who really loves bright colours. So it was my husband's Nana. Lovely Nana Huia. So we had to fly to New Zealand for it. So we went to the church and the coffin is sitting there up on this sort of slight rise. Do you call it a stage? Because my instinct is to call it a stage. What
altar?
Is the front bit?
Was it on
Annie,
wheels?
You don't know. No, so the coffin's on a stand, but the stand's on a slightly raised bit at the front of the room.
Ah, step? I don't know. I don't think there's an official name.
I came here for answers. So I've got a 2.5-year-old in a funeral home. Everyone is quiet or crying, runs up on the stage and starts dancing around the coffin. And I've got the 7-month-old on my lap that I'm trying to keep quiet. So I'm like, I just whisper sort of sweetly to Wade, get her, right? Okay. And my mother-in-law turns around and she goes, no, you have to let her come to you.
Oh.
So I just had to watch my 2.5-year-old dance around the coffin, read the room, you know, like not just ruining the vibe.
I'm driving you towards the airport, but we're not going to the airport. Where are we going?
The plane viewing area. You know, have you?
I've never been. I've lived in Melbourne my whole life and I've never.
Yeah, there's a real hangout.
It sounds loud out there when a plane takes off.
You don't try and talk through the majesty of a plane.
This is the parking lot and the airport's right over there.
Yeah. So not every time. Most of the planes that take off though come right over our heads.
And now we have to go on.
Behold!
Later.
How does it stay?
Ah! And that's why we're comedians. And not pilots.
How many crying little babies and toddlers
are up there right now?
I don't want to go back. Gosh, it was hard. Flying with little ones is a real pain, especially international.
Do you apologise?
Yeah, I sweat with apology. So I'm dripping apology. I just feel so awful about it. Man, if you've ever had a crying baby on a flight, you become so much more sympathetic to people with crying babies on the flight. Very few people with a crying baby on a flight.
That's a great point.
Would be there if they could be anywhere else.
So what happened with your 2-year-old on the way back?
We're driving back to the airport and the kids are in the back. And she just pipes up and in this little voice, quite monotone, so it almost sounded like a horror film, just went, "Mummy gone die one day." And I'm like, you know, it was like, I just reached to the first thing that I remember my mum saying to me, which is like, well, yes, but not for a very long time. You know, because that's the thing with funerals. I guess that's how all the rituals build up. It's just people just reaching for the thing that gave comfort last time. And then this whole rule book develops out of that. So I'm like, not for a very long time. Nearly ran us off the road though.
Oh man.
Anyway, so I'm like, I did it. Good job me. I think I like exchanged a glance with Wade, like nailed it. Kept driving. And then she went, "I gone die one day."
Oh.
And I'm like, depends how you behave at the next funeral, babe.